The battlefields of Syria look and sound just the same after the US cruise missile strikes. There's little doubt, though, that the American action has inwardly shaken Syrian government forces as they continue air raids and ground attacks. It's what happens next that perplexes everyone, especially those who lose out most in the fighting, the civilians. Saturday saw hundreds more leaving Al Waer, the besieged district of Homs, a city that was one of the focal points of the revolution. Now it's in the final stages of a surrender. The opposition calls this forced displacement, ethnic cleansing. The government describes it as a reconciliation agreement. Less than 40 kilometers south, what's left of the Shayarat airbase marks a new milestone in this war. The next move may well be decided by foreign powers. At the UN, the United States calls its attack limited action.
The United States took a very measured step last night. We are prepared to do more, but we hope that will not be necessary.
Russia says it's blatant aggression.
As we see it, you have chosen a different path. We must recall, when you take your own path, that this leads to horrible tragedies for countries in the region and the people living there. Think of the consequences. Remember what you have produced in the Middle East.
Syria says the US is engaged in terrorism. And in Iran, Syria's main ally, President Hassan Rouhani, has now called for a full, impartial inquiry.
What we seek is the formation of an international fact-finding committee. However, its members must not be partial people and must not be headed by the Americans. Neutral countries should come together and assess to make it clear where the chemical weapons came from and who took them there.
So has this, the first direct attack on Assad forces by the US, changed the dynamics of this war? Well, it's drawn a line in the sand, maybe, but to actually weaken Assad, much more political pressure needs to be put on Russia. And it appears that more limited US military action can't be ruled out against Assad forces. Andrew Simmons, Al Jazeera, Beirut.